So, for our first job, I couldn't come up with anything better than what any new idol could hope for, just some face-to-face hard selling. Though, there are a lot of places we could try going. TV stations, record labels, even convenience stores. Only problem is... Yukiho, weren't you just telling me how much you wanted to try hard at your first job a moment ago? Yet, here you are refusing to go anywhere now. Would you at least explain to me what happened, please?
That's because you never told me we'd have to go out and talk to people!
Well, I did only just drop our schedule. What I don't get is why going around talking to people is such a bad thing?
Because I'm bad with strangers, and you want to and you want me to talk all friendly with them right away, like I know them. I can't do that.
Yukiho, I certainly know what it's like to be shy around strangers, but look, could you please show me your face at least?
Show you my face?
I mean.
What?
I'm sorry. I'm out of it, and it sounded funny.
Okay.
Yep. I mean, isn't it kind of weird for us to be conversing across a door? I'd like to be able to at least look at you when I talk to you. Please?
Alright. I understand.
Okay, well, that's better than before at least, though I still think you're standing kind of a little too far away from me.
I'm sorry, producer. To you, it may be just visiting TV stations and talking to strangers, but for me it's, well...
By all accounts, so it would seem.
Oh... I think it would be a little less difficult for me if we could possibly not visit places where there are a lot of men around. Maybe. Oh, and places with lots of dogs, too. Only in that case change less difficult into less impossible. Probably.
I can't imagine where we'd be making a sales pitch to... I can't imagine where we'd be making a sales pitch to that we'd have to contend with a bunch of dogs, but... More to the point, you seem to have a lot of things you'd rather not deal with, Yukiho. A lot of things. The more of those you have, the harder a time you'll have doing... anything.
Producer, are you going to tell me that you're already sick of dealing with me, or...?
Well, it's true, her attitude has set us back right out of the gate, but do I really want to go the route... Do I really want to go the route of telling her something like that? No, Yukiho, I'm not getting sick of you or anything like that. Come on, wipe that worried look off your face.
Really? Oh, I'm so glad.
What are you crying for this time? I thought I was trying to get you to cheer up, right?
Yes, I know, but...
Just stop crying, alright? Here, look at me. Do these look like the eyes of someone who's sick of you?
Dad!
What? Why are you looking at me like that?
I knew it. I really am repulsive to you, producer. I can tell just by looking you in the eyes. I should have known it was impossible for me to be an idol all along. I'm just a worthless, good-for-nothing girl.
Yukiho, stop it! Calm down, please! When did you ever hear me say any of that about you?
Uh. someone, then I'll have no choice but to retire sooner or later, or a lot sooner. It was only a short time, but thank you so much for tolerating me.
And so Yukiho pulled the plug on her all-too-short idol career and left 765 in search of a different way to reinvent herself. Bad end?
Like how?! We only just started together, Yukiho! At least give it 1 week before you give up on everything!
Yes! Sorry.
Yeah, there's no question that what this girl needs is more self-confidence. That's why I really wanted to help make her first job a success. Alright, think, Hana. If she gets nervous talking to strangers face to face, shouldn't there be some other way we could get her talking? Say, Yukiho, what if, instead of visiting a TV station, we had you pitch yourself over the phone instead?
Over the phone? But how would we even do that?
Well, I'm sure we could call up the producer in charge of the station and get you and him, or her, talking.
A phone call with a stranger? You know, I think I might actually be able to do that!
Alright, now you're talking! Let's get to it right away. I'll handle the dialing and the phone tree and stuff, so you just wait and get ready for the talk, okay?
Okay!
And so I quickly contacted one of our go-to stations and raised their producer. Brrr, brrr. Hello, producer speaking.
I'm so sorry to suddenly call you out of nowhere. My name is Hagiwara Yukiho.
Hagiwara Yukiho? I don't believe I've heard your name before, though your number tells me you're with our friends at 765.
Yes, I'm an idol under 765 production.
Hey, not bad. She's starting to calm down and get into it. And after talking with the producer for 2 or 3 minutes... There you go! Congratulations! See? You can do it! I knew you had it in you!
Thank you very much! He told me that next time he wanted to meet me face to face. You know what, producer? All of a sudden I feel like I might somehow be able to make it as an idol after all!
Music to my ears! Well then, what do you say we hurry and hit up other places while we're on a roll? It was just a hunch, but lucky for us, she really can make quite the impression with just her voice. You know what, Yukiho? We might just make a top idol out of you yet. We set up an event for the girls to hand out autographed posters today. There's actually a surprising number of fans flooding the storefront already. Question is Yukiho ready to receive them? Yukiho? What are you moaning about over there? You know we have to start soon, right?
Producer, please tell me, what should I do?
I don't know what you're talking about. If there's something you're worried about, would you tell me what it is, please?
I'm worried about all the presents I have to hand out to the fans at this event.
What? Presents? Yukiho, that doesn't make sense. You're planning on giving presents to the fans in addition to the autographed posters?
Yes! I owe my fans so much, but they almost never get any chances to meet us in person, and I just felt like it would be inhospitable of me not to leave them all with a little extra present at the very end.
At the very what?
Least. Wake up, Kage!
Yukiho, you've got it all backwards. I don't know if you're aware of this, but normally at these meet and greets, it's customary for the fans to bring presents they want to give to their favorite idols. Not the other way around.
No buts.
You're the idol here, and you have a responsibility to act the part. Although, if there is one thing you can leave them with... Just offer them love.
A single moment of your undivided attention and affection is worth far more to a fan than any material good could ever be.
It's worth that much? Really?
I'm not kidding, Yukiho. Think about it from their perspective. They have a once-in-a-lifetime chance to meet face-to-face with someone they idolize. Wouldn't that likely make them pretty nervous? And, well, I think few would be able to empathize with them as well as you could, yes?
Yes, I understand perfectly. If I had to do that, I'd just want to run away and hide.
Right. But wouldn't it make you feel so much better if you went up to her and your idol reassured you with a caring smile, like she genuinely wanted to be your friend?
Oh, I think I get it. So I need to show them hospitality not with things, but with my feelings? I thought all my studies of tea culture would come in handy here, but I guess they were no help at all. At least now I know for next time, I guess.
Right. Don't feel bad. You learned something, and that's a good thing. Anyway, with that in mind, you should probably try to just relax and not worry about giving out presents.
Yeah, I'll forget about that idea. Oh, except, do you think it would still be too much for me to at least give out words, if not things?
Well, I should hope not. What did you have in mind?
Well, I just want to make sure my fans are fully aware of the depth of my gratitude towards them. I mean, I know keeping up my normal work is technically a way to pay them back already, but since today is such a rare opportunity for all of us,
It's okay, Yukiho. I understand exactly how you feel. And to be perfectly honest, I think a gift of words is a wonderful idea.
You really think so?
Yeah, they're unlikely to forget anything that happens today of all days, but especially anything you say to them. In that magical moment when you meet face to face. As for the best thing to say, though...
Oh, I actually already have an idea about that.
Oh, really? Mind if I try to guess what you're thinking? Maybe something to the effect of...
Oh, God.
Thanking them for always supporting you or something?
Yes, exactly! I just want them to know how much I appreciate them. Even though I'm good for nothing, they still cared enough about me to help me get this far. They need to know that. They need to know that I know that it's all thanks to them.
Well, your heart for your fans is in the right place, at least. I'm sure they'll understand the depth of your feelings just fine.
Yes, I'll make sure of it. I'm going to go out there and say thank you to every last person who has supported me with their kindness.
Sounds great, Yukiho. Good luck out there.
Thanks. Then I'll see you afterwards.
Putting herself down notwithstanding, that's an impressive attitude for her to take. She may not be a fully-fledged idol just yet, but... Oh! My goodness, Yukiho, what is it? Did you forget something?
Yes, I did. Producer, thank you for always supporting me. Okay, bye! Oh.
If I didn't know any better, I'd say she was trying to guilt me into promoting her to full-fledged idol in my mind. Well, either way, I'm pretty sure we don't have anything to worry about for today. Oh god, now I have to do this radio show host. We don't
oh
have...
Oh god, who was it?
It was This Is a Thing, wasn't it?
I think so. I think it was. It was either him or it was Gen.
I think Gen was the producer in the first scene.
Right.
Had there been any other option, I'd have taken it. New idols are usually advised to avoid appearing on this radio show. For a particular reason.
Oh, producer!
What's up, Yukiho? Are you all finished with the debriefing?
Yes! Oh, speaking of which, I wanted to tell you about something pretty funny that happened at the meeting. Listen to this! So it seems like the show's director had to pull an all-nighter last night, so when he showed up for the meeting, he looked really sleepy. And And so the whole meeting, he kept dozing off for moments at a time. But there was one point when he suddenly shouted out in the loudest possible voice, "Sensei!" You know, kind of like he'd been dreaming he was a student falling asleep in class. But then right after he did that... another half asleep director actually answered, "Yes, Kato." It was just too funny.
That is a funny story. Also fairly long. Say, I have a question. Do you think you could tell that same story faster and more succinctly?
Succinctly? I'm sorry. I didn't mean to waste your time by talking your ear off for so long.
No, that's not what I was getting at. It has to do with the show you'll be on. There's actually a bit of an issue.
An issue? What is it?
It's the personality they have hosting it. Emperor Iwashi. He's just about the biggest motor mouth you'll ever meet.
Motor mouth? That means basically that he talks really fast, right?
Right. And he's, well, pretty infamous for taking offense to guests not being able to keep up with his pace. That's why newer idols don't usually do this show. There's, unfortunately, no shortage of unpleasant rumors regarding up-and-coming idols falling afoul of him and subsequently meeting a maybe not entirely unrelated early retirement.
Oh, I see. But I don't think that'll be a problem for me. I think I'm actually pretty good with tongue twisters and things like that, you know?
Really? Huh. Wasn't expecting that reaction. Alright then, can I hear a tongue twister now? Try this one.
Oh god, you're gonna make me do this.
Yeah. You know, I think getting it wrong a specific way would be even more difficult than getting it right.
I know, right?
Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. You probably know that one, right? Everybody does.
Uh-huh. Okay, I'll try it. Peter Piper pipped a peck of pickled peppers!
You nailed it!
I actually had to pay attention to what I was saying.
Are you sure you can do this? Should I tell you what you just said?
That was just a test run! It doesn't count! This time, it's for real! Peter Piker picked a peck of pippled peckers!
Pippled peckers now, huh? Sorry, Yukiho, but I don't think you're as good at that as you say.
Probably right. What am I going to do then, producer? At this rate, I'll just be dragging the unit down. Oh, I know! I could just not say anything at all and leave all the talking to the other girls. Does that sound okay?
No. I still think it'd make a pretty bad impression if Iwashi-san specifically talks to you only for you to remain silent. Besides, we're here to advertise the three of you as a unit, but no one can see you on the radio, so if you don't say anything, people will come away with the idea that we only have a unit of two. You're gonna have to contribute to the conversation somehow.
I know all that, but we know that I can't just suddenly talk that fast when I need to, and...
Yeah, you know, maybe the next best thing would be if you at least had a way to get your point across to him... without having to actually say anything.
Oh, I don't understand. What are you talking about, producer?
Like, say if you had a way to answer the Emperor's questions faster than you could with your mouth, you wouldn't have to throw off his groove.
Another way to answer faster than my mouth? I have no idea what that would even be.
Well, it's not hard. In fact, I do it all the time.
Producer, what exactly are you trying to point out, please?
Look outside yourself, Yukiho. You can use everything around you to carry the conversation.
Use everything around me? How would that work?
Suppose, for example, he asks you what time it is. Instead of trying to talk fast, you could just quickly point to the clock.
Well, I see what you're saying. Yeah, that actually seems like it could be a lot faster than talking. I think I'm going to try that then. You can look forward to a great broadcast, okay, producer?
Okay, Yukiho, we're counting on you. During the broadcast. I neglected to rehearse this, by the way.
Now you know my feelings with Vitsko.
Hello and good afternoon. Washi here with the Machine Gun Talk Show, and we'll have to cut it short there because today is my... never mind, what was I saying? Oh, yes, guests, we have wonderful guests joining us today. Please give a big hand for Hana, Yori, clap. Remember, it's a good thing for a group to have. Miss Tuggan, hi, how are you? Tell you some hobbies, your talents, your age, and your favorite food, please, in that order. God, that was awful. Members, good thing for a group to have. Miss Hakimoto Yukiho, hi, how are you? Tell us your hobbies, your talents, your age, and your favorite food, please, in that order. Me? Stop right there, ladies and gentlemen. She just pointed at me. I think I'm a hobby of hers. Yes, you hear that, folks? I'm finally on my way to being the next big thing with the kids these days. Just like Yukiho-chan herself. Here's looking at you, kid. Damn, that guy talks fast. But hey, it worked. Not only did Iwashi not miss a beat, he seems to have taken a liking to her even. Not bad, Yukiho. The show went on just like that, with Iwashi in the best of moods the whole time and nobody getting thrown out a window. And it'll be great publicity for the girls, thanks to him calling each of them by name repeatedly. Glad we made it out of this one, okay. Oh, I'm pretty sure you did do it that fast, this is a thing. So, I thought we had secured extra roles in a film today, but I really screwed up this time. Damn it. Why didn't I think to check for stipulations like this beforehand? The girls are going to be so upset when they find out no one will even see them.
I'm back! I'm sorry you had to wait so long, producer. hey, can I tell you something? I was in the hallway just now and... producer? Did something happen? Why is your face all scrunched up like... are you not feeling all... are you... what? Are you feeling alright?
I'm so sorry, Yukiho. Really. I just found out you're gonna have to wear animal suits for this shoot, and... I'm really sorry.
Let me see if I remember right. We were all supposed to be extras for a film shoot today, right?
I'm really, really sorry. It's my fault for not confirming the details ahead of time. Please forgive me. I won't do it
again. Oh, is that all it is?
Okay. I know you're upset faces, Yukiho, and this isn't one of them. What is going through that head of yours?
Just a side note, I really hate the starry outfits.
At least they're not flashing when they're not on stage.
It's not even about the flashing, it's about how gaudy they look.
I mean, to just laugh off such a glaring mistake without getting mad at me at all. You'd practically have to be in love with me, or...
But being in love with you, that's...
Okay, maybe it's my fault for the poorly timed joke, but to have it denied that strongly just hurts my feelings.
No, I didn't mean to make you feel like I was denying you, okay? I was talking about the reason I started giggling earlier. I couldn't help it. I was just so relieved and happy to know you weren't injured or in pain or anything. That's all.
Okay, so what are you getting at?
What am I getting at? Well, that I was really worried about you, producer, so I... doesn't matter anymore. Can we stop talking about this already? The point is we're both fine, so no more moping!
You're right. If I have time to mope, I should be using it to make up for my mistake by doing better work. Before you all get sick of me and start asking for a new producer.
Well, we wouldn't do that, of course. But thank goodness. I'm used to seeing you in a good mood, producer. Puts my mind at ease, too.
Thanks, Yukiho. So, now that we've pulled ourselves together, you want to go try on those costumes?
Yes!
Of course they're not playing trees. This isn't Mega Man Star Force.
I'm glad that's taken care of. My costume was actually pretty cute, wasn't it, producer?
Yeah, and a suspiciously good fit for something so hastily thrown together. Makes you wonder. But now we gotta tell the other girls about this whole mess and get their costumes fitted. Not looking forward to that.
In that case, producer, could you let me?
You'd be willing to tell the others for me, Yukiho? I appreciate that, but... this really is something I need to do myself. There's no meaning to the apology unless I'm the one who delivers it.
But you really looked like you were starting to get depressed again just now. So if you didn't want to do it, I thought...
Whether I want to do it or not is irrelevant. I have a responsibility to you girls, and I shouldn't be shirking it. I just gotta face the music and tell him straight up. I'm your producer, I can handle it. Come on, you can at least let me pretend I'm awesome once in a while.
What do you mean, let you pretend, producer? Of course not. You're already...
I lost my kage.
What?
There you go. Your sound cut out for a second.
Oh.
It was right after you finished your line. Sorry, I didn't catch all of that. Your voice cut out. Sorry, I didn't catch all of that. I'm already what?
Already? No, I said please hurry back as soon as you're already.
Oh, you got it. I'd probably get you all worried about me again if I took too long, huh? I promise I won't. All right, I'll be back in a snap, Yukiho. Can I count on you to check over the script for us until then?
Come back soon, producer.
I'll see you later, Yukiho. The other girls were shocked to hear about the news at first, of course. But we still managed to reach an understanding. Perhaps in part because I made the effort to be honest and apologize. It's not how we fall, it's how we rise again. Though I admit this time, I probably would have lost it if Yukiho hadn't been so compassionate towards me. Thank you, Yukiho. Alright, skipping over Iori's after communication for now. Yes! Done with work, and suddenly tomorrow's a day off for some reason. Well, it's a nice surprise. I feel like a giddy school kid on a snow day. And since I don't have anything I need to do for once, it actually feels like a day off, too. Some peace and quiet, a good cup of coffee. What could be better? Oh, that's easy. If only I had a nice girlfriend to enjoy it with. Also, I don't drink coffee.
Ting-a-ling-a-ling.
Welcome, Miss.
Oh, wait. This Yzmi wanted to do lightning for this one last time, and she didn't get to.
Oh. Go ahead, lightning.
Welcome, Miss. Just one today?
Yes, but I'm expecting someone else, too, later.
And allow me to show you inside so you can find a seat. This way, please.
Thank you!
That voice sounds familiar.
Let's see. Where's the emptiest place to sit?
Wait for it.
Over there, maybe? Ah! Producer! What are you doing here?
Good morning to you too, Yukiho. It's just a coincidence. What are you acting so surprised for?
What about you, producer?
all by yourself?
Unfortunately, yes. Couldn't really make plans to invite anyone else since we just suddenly got a day off in the middle of the week. But come on, enough about me. What brings you here, Yukiho?
I'm actually waiting to meet someone here.
What the? That was coy even for her. Why don't I like the sound of this? Not to pry, but would this someone happen to be... a girl? Seems a little more likely to me. Maybe another one of the girls from our agency?
Yes, you guessed exactly right, actually.
Uh-huh. So which one of them are you waiting for?
Oh, she's...
Ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling.
Welcome, miss. Dress yourself today?
Thanks, but no. I have a friend here waiting for me already. I'll just let myself in. No, miss. Stop right there.
Guess that answers that question.
Chipper?
Oh. I'm here, Yukiho. Sorry to have keep you waiting. Hey! Who the hell invited this one to tag along?
Great, it's you. What was your name again?
Here, I'll move it over here so you can actually see her face. Yes. Since I can do this without it.
The Ryugu Komachi member, Minase Iori?
Member? What's wrong with you? That's not how you pronounce ace. Last time I checked. But far more pressingly, Yukiho, do you mind explaining to me what compelled you to show up here with this thing?
Still sitting right here, for the record.
No, Yori-chan, you don't understand. It's just a coincidence that we both got here around the same time.
Oh? Coincidence? Don't tell me you took his word for it. Never mind that. We have the day off. You just couldn't bring yourself to leave poor Yukiho alone for 2 minutes, could you?
Stop it! It's not like that, and you know it! I'd appreciate you not trying to make me out to be some kind of stalker.
Aw, it was just a little joke.
Oh my god, then keep your voice down! You think it's a joke? You try having the waitress look at you like she wants you arrested. Or purged.
Inconsequential trivialities.
Inconsequential trivialities. Isn't it unproducer-like to be so nitpicky or whatever? But enough about you. Where are we sitting, Yukiho?
Oh, right. I was thinking that empty spot over there would be good.
Alright, looks good to me. Oh, yeah. Hey, producer, lately Ritsuko's been speaking pretty highly how hard you're working, though you'd like to know.
Thought you'd like to know. I hope that's another one of your jokes, because if not, all it really does is put more pressure on me. I'm not even close to her level yet.
Well, whatever you're doing, just keep it up. See ya!
There she goes, and poof, peace and quiet again. Finally. But why would Yukiho be meeting in private with Iori? Does she want to ask for her advice on something? If that's the case, then evidently she doesn't trust me as much as I had hoped just yet, huh?
So, Iori-chan, if you're in a love situation and...
What? Did she just say love? Love as in love?
That's a tough one. But I found the best advice in general is to just go for it. You gotta have total commitment from both partners. That's important.
I still have so little experience, though. I really hope I don't just screw everything up.
more I overhear of this conversation, the less convinced I get that it's nothing to worry about. Be objective, Hana. What's the best course of action? Well, obviously I could just call her over and ask her about it up front, couldn't I? I'm just looking out for her as her producer. Surely she wouldn't think any less of me for it. Even if it turns out to be nothing to worry about. Yukiho, may I speak to you for a minute?
Coming. What do you need me for, producer?
Well, no, I was just curious what you were talking about with Yori, and if whatever it was something I could help with. I mean, you know I'm always here for you if you need advice, right? I just don't want you to feel like you have to be shy about coming to me first if there's something on your mind. Even if it's about, well, relationships and...
Okay, I'll keep that in mind. I'm so lucky you're such a kind person, producer.
What? No, that's not where I was going with that. Alright, what were you two talking about over there?
Nothing really, just...
Yori-chan and I will be playing tennis together later. I was just asking her for tips.
Tennis?
Yeah. She's been asking me about ways to stay in shape, since she doesn't have to. She doesn't want to neglect her health and have it adversely affect her work.
I get it. So it was a work-related discussion. Sorry, when I heard you mention love, I thought for sure you were...
Yes? You thought for sure I was... what, producer?
Nothing! Nothing to worry about at all. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So that's what's up. Not too shabby, Yukiho. Guess you're a smoother... operator than you let on, aren't you?
Hey, put a lid on it already! Don't rub off your weird misunderstandings on her!
Well, we've had our girl talk, so I think it's just about time you to treat...
For you.
For you to treat us to lunch here, wouldn't you say? In exchange, of course, for me putting a lid on it and leaving this conversation where it stands. Agreed?
You're an ace haggler, I'll give you that much. Fine, I'll do it. Lunch is on me, girls.
Really? Thank you so much, Yori-chan. Oh, and you too, producer.
Don't mention it. Love. Tennis. I walked right into that one. I was really worried for a moment there, though. But even on her own time, Yukiho's still working so hard to improve herself. I could probably stand to follow her example. On another note, despite all appearances, Yori's actually pretty dangerous. I'm gonna have to start being more careful not to let her joke around at my expense. Okay, finally I get to go home. Let's see, tomorrow is... off? Nice. Maybe I should just go out somewhere and have fun. You know, I'd give anything for just one day off where something doesn't come up to ruin it all to hell. Honestly, where could I have dropped that wallet? I haven't been able to find it anyway. Hey, look who it is. Yukiho? Hey, Yuki! What's she doing? She's acting kind of weird. Almost looks like she might be looking around for something, too. I wonder. Anyway, Yukiho! Hey! What are you doing over there?
Producer? Oh, what's going on? Why are you here?
Yeah, about that. I think I dropped my wallet somewhere, and I've been out looking for it.
Oh no! Really?
Yes, really, I'm afraid. But What are you doing at the office, Yukiho? You know we have today off, right?
Me too, actually.
Yeah, that's why I just said... Oh, you mean you lost something too?
I lost my wallet somewhere too. And I've been looking for it for a really long time now.
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, imagine that. I guess that makes us both... At least we get to be losers of wallets together, then. That's something.
Oh, now that you mention it, that kind of cheers me up a little when you put it that way, I think.
Well, good. You know, just as long as we don't get too happy about it. So, what kind of wallet did you lose? If I know what it looks like, I could help you keep an eye out for it.
You'll really help me? Okay, it's a pink wallet. Pink.
Okay, understood. Look for something very, very pink. Well then, shall we continue our wallet hunting expeditions together?
Okay. Thank you so much, producer. I'm so glad you lost your wallet too for me.
Yeah? Is it weird that I'm happy to hear that? I feel like it should be. How about we just get going?
Okay!
She can be such a space case sometimes.
I know.
Nothing. I hate to say it, but I think we're having about as much luck as can be expected, Yukiho.
You're right. And the police hadn't had anyone turn them in either. I wonder if I'll ever see my poor wallet again.
Aw, come on. No crying aloud, okay? We can find them if we just keep looking. Just keep it up.
Alright.
You know what would really help is if they could lend us a police dog. Finding our wallets would be a snap if we had...
Those are really huge dogs, though, aren't they? You know how I am with dogs, producer. I can never be around one that big!
Yeah, right. Sorry.
But, I don't think we need one. I could be our police dog instead.
What?! And just how exactly do you plan to fill in for a police dog?
I just have to memorize your scent and follow it to your wallet. That's what they do, right? If even a dog can do it, then there's no way I can't.
No. Yukiho, dogs can do that because they're dogs, okay? They can pick out one air molecule out of a trillion. Their olfactory senses are orders of magnitude
We're not getting anywhere just wandering around like this. Besides, you don't need a dog when you have me here for you, producer, and I'm going to prove it.
She's taking this weirdly personally for some reason. Though she's right that we're pretty much at an impasse. Should I even try to keep arguing? Okay, you're right. We probably need to try everything we can think of at this point. Go ahead, Yukiho.
Yay! Well then, if I may, please pardon me for just a moment, okay, producer? Okay, I see. So this is what you smell like, producer.
Yukiho? Any closer and I swear I could hear your heartbeat.
I'm sorry! I was so focused on picking up your scent, I didn't even realize how close I was! I'm so sorry!
No! Please! Don't worry about it! It's not that I... Not that I particularly minded you being so close or anything... More importantly, did it help?
Sorry, my head is like... total mess right now, so I don't have a clue.
Oh, can't blame you for that. I don't know anymore, Yukiho. If not even that's gonna work, we need to think up. Hey. There's something very, very pink by your feet. That wouldn't happen to be...
Huh? You're right! It's my wallet! How did it suddenly get here?
You think maybe it got stuck somewhere in your clothes? I mean, you were bouncing around and fidgeting quite a bit just a few seconds ago. Maybe that dislodged it?
Was it? Oh no! I remember now! I was afraid of losing my wallet, so I tucked it beneath my clothes! And now I've gone and caused you so much trouble for no reason! I'm really sorry!
No, Yukiho, I'm just happy for you that you found it! You're not supposed to be upset now! Be happy! Smile! Come on. Like this. Smile.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Thank goodness. I don't care what some of her fans might say, she looks far better with a smile on her face than with tears. But there's more to that smile than a pretty face. There's pure happiness that I want to do everything I can to protect.
By the way, producer?
Yeah, what is it, Yukiho?
I was only wondering, but just now, I thought I noticed a very, wallet-looking thing sticking out of your back pocket.
God! Now I remember! I needed my other hand coming out of the convenience store, and I just stuffed it there.
Good for you, producer. You and I really are the exact same today. That makes me so happy.
You're right. Well, as thanks for finding my wallet for me, how about I take you out for a quick bite to eat? I don't know about you, but I haven't had a chance to eat yet since I've been out doing this all day.
Sure! I'm actually pretty hungry myself. Today really did turn out to be a good day after all, didn't it, producer?
You know, it's funny. Even if just one thing can ruin a day to hell. Just one more thing afterward could turn out to be the proverbial spider's thread. I mean, not only did we both find our wallets, now I get to pretend to go out with Yukiho. Might be best to keep today a secret from the other girls, huh? All right, we're done for the day. Time to go home. A little late for the president to be calling. Did something happen? I hope not. Bleep! Hello? Ah! You mean right now? Understood, sir. Yes, I can put in a little overtime.
Think I'd be working all night. No fair hitting me with a huge data processing shift just as I'm leaving, President. We really don't have enough clerical staff. When's he gonna hire Poro Tanashi-san? More help. I should talk to her next time. We should totally do that one thing. Organize a... Oh, was it a hunger... Hunger streak?
Producer!
Hunger... stroke? Oh! Yukiho. What a coincidence. What's she doing here?
Well, I thought I could come out here and practice my no date for a while, since it's such a nice day today.
No date. Sorry, what's that again, please?
No date is a tea ceremony. Basically, it involves sitting down outside while the host prepares tea for the guests to drink. I usually practice in the garden at home. And a bunch of my father's disciples from all over the country are meeting at the house today. So, my usual place is too crowded.
Disciples from all over? Sounds like a hassle, I guess. Sorry.
Producer? You don't look too well. Are you okay? What were you doing out here anyway?
Oh, I just had to stay late doing some extra clerical work at the office last night. I was on my way home.
You mean you've been working all night? Are you sure you're all right, producer?
Yeah, well, I feel, I'm in tip-top shape. I'll be fine, so you don't have to worry, huh? Okay, Yukiho?
Are you really, really sure? I don't know. You really don't look like your usual self.
She can still tell. I guess she pays closer attention to me than I thought. That makes me kind of happy, I guess.
I have an idea, producer.
What is it, Yukiho?
Can't believe I'm suggesting this. Do you want to come over to my house? It's actually not far from here at all, so you could...
Well, I would appreciate that, and I kind of was dying to see what on earth you were talking about when you mentioned disciples, but I don't think it would be a good idea. Didn't you say you came out here to get away from the crowds over there today? Sorry, that may have been extra long, but it's still just a stage direction.
Oh, okay.
They all are when they're like that.
Okay.
Yeah, I forgot I did. I'm really sorry I couldn't be of any help to you, producer.
Professor?
Wake up, Kage!
I'm the one who's tired. That's not true, Yukiho. Just knowing how much you care about me makes me feel better. In fact, I might even be able to get all the way home now.
Are you sure? You still don't, look much better, producer.
Don't you worry, sweetheart. I'll be just that.
Hey! You stumbled just a bit now. I saw you!
Yeah. Guess there's no denying that.
This really isn't good, producer. I don't want you trying to go all the way home like this. If you can think of anything at all that I can do for you, please just ask. I really want to help you any way I can.
Is she really genuinely that concerned for me? Maybe she'd feel better if I at least asked her for something.
To be fair, this is the thing, the professor thing might have stemmed from the fact that I'm rereading Harry Potter.
Alright then, would you mind, pampering me for a little while, Yukiho?
Pamper you, producer? I don't even know. What do you want me to do exactly?
Sorry, I just said the first thing that popped into my head. I'm too sleepy to make sense, okay?
You must be really sleepy, producer. Okay, maybe I can do this for you? I already set up my nodate over there, so let me make you some tea. It has caffeine in it, so I think it'll help you at least make it back to your house without falling asleep.
Okay. Guess I should have some then. Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay then, come over here.
Mix.
I'll be ready. What?
What?
It'll be ready in just a minute, producer. Don't worry about the rules or etiquette or anything. Just drink it up.
flop.
I don't know. Producer, what's wrong? No,
that's a... Sorry, maternal realization.
Oh, okay.
What's wrong? Oh. Sweet dreams, producer.
Where?
You woke up! How do you feel, producer?
Yukiho. Did I, fall asleep here?
Uh-huh. You looked like you were sleeping really comfortably.
Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to keep you waiting here for me. Wait. Was I comfortable? You're right, that's weird. I wouldn't expect to feel so well rested from sleeping on the ground. And I could swear I remember feeling something soft and warm beneath my head, too.
Please stop! You're not allowed to think about that any further, alright? I'm just gonna go home now, okay? Bye!
Yukiho, wait! Damn, never seen her move that fast.
That was so embarrassing!
Was she giving me a lap pillow or something just now? Man, do I feel better. I had no idea Yukiho had such a maternal side. That was really sweet of her. I'll be sure to thank her properly next time. Oh, but maybe not in front of the other girls, though. Better wait until the next time it's just the two of us. Lest we cause any undue misunderstandings. We came to this indoor beach resort to film a PV today. Blue skies, balmy breezes. This is perfect artificial weather for a shoot.
Producer!
There you are, Yukiho.
Producer, did you see over there? It looks so romantic with all those rocks shaped like little stars and stuff.
Uh-huh. I was wondering where you had gotten off to. Just looking around?
Uh-huh. I could never come out to a place like this all on my own, so everything here is so new and exciting.
I can understand that. This really isn't the type of place you'd typically come out to all alone, despite the president's best efforts. But we're not here just to play around, remember? There'll be time for that later. They'll all be waiting for you at the shoot. Might want to go get changed and...
Ah! Over there, producer! Doesn't that look like a pretty interesting building? Let's go check it out!
What? No, later, Yukiho. Listen, I'm saying if you want to make sure we can start filming on time, you should change into your...
Yo, that reminds me! I tried making my own bento last night and brought it with me! Hey, producer, let's go over there and eat it together, okay?
All right. I can tell there's definitely something you're trying to distract me from, Yukiho. Do you not actually want to do this shoot? You can tell me.
You can tell? I should have known I couldn't hide it from you.
Yeah, well, I think anyone would have been tipped off to that. Can't remember you ever behaving so obliquely with me. Although, if I had to guess why, is it about having to wear a swimsuit?
Yeah, I mean, the shoot will be in front of whole crowds of staff members, mostly guys I don't know, right? And you're asking me to go out there practically naked in front of all of them? How could you expect anyone to do something so humiliating?
Yukiho, stop! Please don't treat me like I'm asking you to strip naked. I care about you more than that. This isn't anything to freak out about so much.
even if it feels more exposing to you, at the end of the day, a swimsuit is just another stage costume. That's how everyone watching will see it.
It's easy for you to say that, since you've never had to go out and pose in one. I know, producer. Deep down, I understand this isn't something I'm supposed to let get to me. My brain knows that, but when I saw the huge crowd of people on staff today, it made me anxious, and I got sort of stage fright the more I thought about it, and...
I understand, Yukiho, but this is an important shoot, and we can't very well do it without you, you know? In fact, while we've been standing here talking about it, the other girls might be waiting to start already.
We could maybe do some scenes with me wearing some other outfit? What do you think about that?
You mean what you're wearing now? We didn't bring anything else.
Why not? I think these clothes could work just fine for shots of playing in the sand or looking for seashells. How does that sound?
Seashells? Well, I guess it has about as much to do with our music as anything else we were planning to shoot here. I'm sorry, Yukiho, but I really can't allow that. I need you to show some solidarity with the other girls here.
Do I really have to?
Yukiho, if the three of you are going to be a unit, then you need to agree to all be in this together. I can't go giving any one of you special consideration when it wouldn't be fair to the others. Think about it. They're both out there right now giving everything they have to put this shoot together for us, even though they might be just as embarrassed to be wearing swimsuits in front of all those strangers. But there's one thing they can take comfort in. At least they don't have to do it alone. Don't you think they'd like to have you there with them? To help them feel more comfortable about it too? So come on, don't be selfish. Do you think you could stick your neck out for them this one time and get changed, please? Oh, and to prove I'm not just high-horsing over here, I'll put on my own swimsuit and go right over there with you, if it'll make you feel better.
Hmm? Really? You'd wear your own swimsuit with me? Maybe I should take you up on that.
If that's what you really want.
Just kidding. It's all right, producer. I'm sorry for my bad behavior. I'll go and get changed into my swimsuit now.
That's really big of you, Yukiho. I'm proud of you.
Thanks. You helped me realize something today. I'm going to try not to be so selfish from now on. Thank you for always looking out for me.
Well, it was touch and go there for a while, but hopefully I managed to get my point across to her without sounding like a creep. Considering the way she happily skipped off, changed into her swimsuit, and completed a marvelous shoot with the other girls. Yeah, that solidarity between the three of them is the one thing I'd like this unit to convey to the world, if nothing else. I can't wait for this PV to hit the air.
Oh god, it's the scene. Guess I'll reprise my role! Hello, sir. Welcome to Namcot, the leading innovator in global convenience.
What? That was wonderful. The original voice actress's voice isn't nearly as subdued as that. I can barely hear you, Yukiho. You'll have to greet your customers with more energy than that. Try another one.
Okay, then. Welcome, ma'am! How would you like to walk out of here right now with some extra hot Oden? Energy! Oden! Energy!
No! See, now you're overdoing it. They'll walk right out of here without anything if you shout at them like that.
If I'm soft, you don't like it. If I'm loud, you don't like it. I keep telling you, this would be too much for me, producer.
Don't start, Yukiho. You know you can get it right. Come on, it won't leave a good impression if the manager sees you crying like this.
But why do I have to be a store clerk all of a sudden? I thought you said we'd just be going around and talking to people today.
I know. Sorry. But the PR guys didn't see much point in us coming all the way out to their store just for that. They wanted us to show them some work as long as we're here, since they're in the middle of looking for new campaign girls, apparently.
And that's okay? I can't just magically turn into a convenience store employee when I have no experience and don't even know the first thing about working at a place like this!
You'll be fine, Yukiho. This isn't really anything you need to study for. Trust me, your most important qualification comes from right here.
Chest? Producer? I don't have a lot of confidence in my chest either, you know? If that's what it takes to lure customers to the store, I could never pull it off in a million years with this chest. No way.
What are you talking about? This isn't a red line. I mean, no! There is no such store anywhere. That's preposterous. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to give you that impression, Yukiho. What I meant was your heart needs to be in the right place. Devotion towards your customers is what's most important.
Devotion towards the customers?
Right. What's important is that they can tell their... What's important is that they can tell their feelings matter to you from how you treat them. As long as they know that, they'll forgive you even if you make a few little mistakes here and there.
Oh, I get it. Making sure my fans know they matter to me is part of my regular job as an idol, too. I read that wrong! Oh, I get it! Making sure my fans know that they matter to me is part of my regular job as an idol, even. So I already know how to do that. That's kind of a relief. I think I understand what I'm supposed to do a little better now. A really tiny little bit better, but...
Well, good. Looks like you're ready to give being clerk for a day another try. We're all counting on you, Yukiho.
Yes, I'll try!
That's the spirit. Kling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling. Oh, looks like we've got a customer. Go on, Yukiho. Go ahead and greet her. Remember what we discussed.
Okay. Hello, miss! Welcome to Namcot, the leading innovator in global convenience. We're currently holding a special on our deep-fried products, featuring these little guys on display here. Please take a look.
There you go. See, you can do it, Yukiho. She actually pulls that off pretty well, doesn't she? Now she's on her way to impressing the manager.
Excuse me, miss, but is there any way I could get this bento heated up, please? Huh? You want it heated up? Please wait a minute, I'll be right back!
Yes? What's going on, Yukiho? Is something wrong?
Producer, help! She asked me to heat up a bento for her, and I don't know how I'm going to do that!
Well, they should have, like, a microwave here that you can use. Simple as that, right?
Sure where, how, or if I'm allowed to. I've never bought a bento from a convenience store myself, so...
Seriously? You haven't once bought a boxed lunch at... Well, maybe I should remember who I'm talking to.
What should I do, producer? If I can't figure this out, I might end up making my first little mistake already!
Calm down, Yukiho. Look, if you're not sure about the microwave, you can just... Just heat it up with your heart.
Huh? With my heart?
Sure. Remember we were talking about devotion earlier? That's a warm feeling, right? Just hold it close and let that warmth wash over it. It'll be chicken soup for the soul and the stomach.
My heart. In the right place. I get it now! So all I have to do is hug it real close to my chest, right? Okay, I'll give it a try.
What? No, wait! Yukiho!
Yukiho! I was just joking around, trying to get you to relax! Obviously, that won't actually work! Oh, boy.
Sorry to have kept you waiting. May I please see that bento? I'm going to heat it up for you with the warmth of my heart! Oopsie-daisy. There, little one. Please just give this a few minutes, okay?
Yukiho! Damn it, this is all my fault. I should have just helped her use the microwave.
Did she come up with that? Bento overflowing with warmth from the heart. That would make for an amazing sale campaign.
Wait, what? I wasn't expecting that whole debacle to actually strike a chord with the manager. He later told us he'll be happy to have them as the store's next campaign girls. I guess even then, one look at Yukiho must have told him she really does care a lot about others, and people appreciate that. We all owe her a big thank you for this one.
That brought back so many memories. That was the first episode that I was in. And not long after that, we started talking regularly on Skype.
I love you.
I love you too.
This is a sporting promotion event where This is a sporting promotion event we're participating in today. The girls are playing in a tennis tournament. Well, the job description said cheerleaders when we took it, but evidently the sponsor had other plans, but I'm not concerned. Yukiho's done this before, right? I mean... what was that, her just now? Is this marathon her idea of a warm-up jog? She's gonna wear herself out before we even start. Hey, Yukiho!
I need produce.
Yeah, about that. You're sounding about as bad as I expected. Shouldn't warm-up exercises be a little less, intense? Yeah, alright, got it. I understand. So, just... take some deep breaths. Just take it easy for a minute and let your breathing return to normal. Okay?
Okay.
There. Looks like it's working pretty fast. How is it? You calm down now? You calm down now? Still going, huh? Well, you were running for all you were worth just a while ago, so I guess...
Give me a second, I feel kind of lightheaded.
Don't... careful!
Oh, God.
What was she even saying? Maybe I should subtitle that part.
That's the point! That's the point!
Okay, never mind then.
Oh, I think I've calmed down a bit. You saved me, producer. Thank you!
No, not at all. I'm just happy you've settled back down. So, you mind telling me why you were going crazy out there? You know the tournament's just a sideshow to excite the audience, right? We don't have to be so worried about actually winning out there.
Yeah, I understand that, but...
But what, Yukiho?
I just thought the
people who play at this event are all coming here to find out their own limits, right? So I thought the people who play... I just lost my spot. So I thought... Yukiho's in an endless loop. If I'm going to play too, then it wouldn't be proper for me not to just put... For me to be just as... Fuck. For me not to be just as serious. But, am I mistaken?
No, I think you have the right of it. I'm sorry, it looks like I was mistaken. What I should be saying is, I'm with you all the way, Yukiho. Hey, wanna go running again? Together this time?
Okay, we'll go together then. Oh, but... wait...
What? Did you think of something else?
If I run any more than this, my legs will be all jelly-like when we play. I think I should move on to my practice swings.
Oh, good idea. That's okay, I can do that together with you too. It'd be way easier with two people anyway. Come on!
Thank you! You know, Professor... God damn it! God damn it! You know, Producer...
Miss Hagiwara?
Shut up! Getting to play tennis with you kind of feels like we took the day off to...
Hey! Yukiho, what are you doing? Come on, let's play! If you're trying to say something, I can't hear you over there! Speak up!
Yes, Producer? Oh, he picks the weirdest times to get all fired up. It's a little hard to deal with sometimes.
Bing bong, bing bong. Paging, Hana Yori Uta team member, Hagiwara Yukiho. Hagiwara Yukiho! Your match will begin in 10 minutes. Please proceed to court 4.
Bong, bing, bong, bing. Sounds like it's your turn, Yukiho. You warmed up? Is your body ready for this now?
Producer, I can't. I'm done.
Oh, what do you mean you're done? Did you completely wear yourself out warming up after all?
It was your training, Producer. It was like hell on Earth. And now I just can't swing my right arm anymore. I'm sorry.
Come to think of it, maybe starting out with 500 reps was a little too harsh a regimen for a novice.
What do I do now? At this rate, I'm going to completely miss my match, and then...
Yukiho, please, don't cry! I'm sorry, this is my fault, so let me massage it for you, okay? All I have to do now is make sure I massage the right place, which is... what did she say again? How's that, Yukiho? Does that feel any better?
No. You're really good at that, Producer. Yeah, I think my arm does kind of feel a little lighter. I think maybe I can more or less make it through the match like this. Thank you very much!
Don't mention it. Obviously, I'd be the one responsible if you did miss your match, so I'm relieved too. Now get out there and win. You've already been to hell and back, right? This match should be a walk in the park for you.
Yes, sir. Wish me luck.
You will win, Yukiho. This is what I want you to experience. Your great efforts bearing fruit.
Ultra smash!
Game, set, and match! Hagiwara Yukiho! She won all her matches, just like that. No doubt due to all that practice. This is what happens when you make a commitment and put forth the effort to succeed, Yukiho. It's how you won this tournament, and it's how we'll take the Grand Prix, too. One step at a time. How you doing?
Okay.
So, the girls were scheduled to be guests on this radio show called 24-Hour Love Advice, but now they've pushed a last-minute change. Might be a little tough for Yukiho to hear, but it's also kind of to her benefit, so...
Producer! Producer! Oh, there you are, producer! I didn't expect to find you here!
Oh, hey! Good timing, Yukiho. There's something I need to talk to you about.
Well, what are we talking about, producer? Why do I have kind of a bad feeling about this?
No, it's nothing bad. It's just about this, radio gig we're doing. They want you to do it solo. Be a solo guest.
Huh? What? But I thought all three of us were supposed to do the show together! What happened to the others?
They're in another booth, doing a different show. I don't know if you've ever met a woman named Ogosho, but apparently we've worked with her before, and she invited us on a whim, and,
But no! I wasn't ready for this to happen today! I can't all of a sudden!
No!
I don't know what my throat did there.
I think you'll be fine if you just keep a cool head, Yukiho. Even without the other girls here, you still have lots of experience from all the different kinds of jobs you've done to go off of, right? You know, in a way, you could think of it as... an exercise in independence. Working as a unit isn't just about the wow factor of group dancing, you know. It also lets you carry out multiple independent activities concurrently and then share all those different experiences with each other.
Share different experiences? So you're saying if we use this case as an example, I'd go on my show, the other girls would go on their show, and at the end of the day we'd all get together and talk about what it was like for each of us?
Exactly. And hearing from them about something that's still new to you might encourage you to go out and try it for yourself sometime.
Wait, then this is kind of a big responsibility if I'm going to have to use my experience to motivate them. Okay, I'll try.
That's the spirit, Yukiho. You can do it. Believe in yourself.
Yeah. What am I supposed to talk about all myself?
All myself?
All by myself!
Well, the show is called 24-Hour Love Advice. I think it's pretty straightforward what they'd want you to talk about.
But I'm pretty sure I'm the absolute worst person to ask about that sort of thing. Everyone knows I'm terrible around boys, but even if I wasn't, look at me. I'm short. I'm a stick. I'm the short end of the stick no one wants. And my total dating experience? A big fat zero. What's a good-for-nothing girl like me supposed to say to anyone about love?
Yeah. I actually had an idea about that. I think you should talk about your ideal first love.
Really? But I don't think anybody'd be interested to hear what I want my first love to be like, would they?
Think about your audience, Yukiho. There's gonna be a lot of teenage girls just like you tuning into this show for advice. And that they're not alone, that there's someone else out there who understands what they're going through, is something they need to hear.
I do understand. Thank you for explaining it to me, producer. If there are people out there that I can help, I'll do it. I'll do anything.
I know you would. Go on, Yukiho. They're counting on you.
Okay.
During the broadcast.
Oh god. Okay.
It's time for more 24-hour love advice. Does that sound like something you need? Then we have the perfect guide for you here today. Introducing the lovely Hagiwara Yukiho-chan.
Wow, I am melting over here.
Shut up. I actually don't have any real experience with relationships just yet, but I do know it's definitely something I want for myself someday, and... My, that's so wonderful, Yukiho-chan. Don't leave us hanging now. Please tell us what your ideal romance would be like, and don't spare any details.
Shut up. I am going to hurt you.
I'm sorry. That was really sexy.
I am going to hurt you.
And so, Yukiho poured out her pure and honest feelings. In addition to hearing an idol open up about herself, her own awkwardness in matters of the heart and her desire for a wonderful partnership seemed to resonate well with the listeners, and the show got a record number of call-ins and messages. I'm sure Yukiho's Prince Charming is out there somewhere, and he'll swoop in to answer her feelings someday. Damn. Whoever he is, I'm kind of jealous of him.
Ha, 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 ha.
Hey, what do you want from me? That was the line in Japanese.
I know. Foreshadowing.
So, there's a TV station sponsoring this musical called Summer Girls, and our girls have been cast for supporting roles. Right now they're doing the final dress rehearsal. I can hear the director barking out orders from here.
It's so hot, producer!
Oh dear. Yukiho, are you alright? You must be having it tougher out there than I imagined. Here, let me fan you for a bit, okay? Just stand still there for a minute.
That feels really good. Kind of feels like I'm cooling off on the back porch of one of those country houses.
Ah, you mean the ones they use for every vacation episode in anime? You know, except for being hot, you seem surprisingly relaxed, considering...
Well, maybe not my body, but I'm having a lot of fun doing this play, so I guess my mind is relaxed, yeah.
Oh? From where I'm watching, it actually seems pretty harsh. Especially the director. You still having fun?
Yeah. I'm learning a lot from the way she shows me how to move and how to use my voice properly. I think my inner actress might be awakening.
Inner actress, huh? That is a harsh road. You know, one thing actresses have to do a lot of is kissing scenes and things like that, so...
But I really think I'd prefer it if I could save my first kiss to be with someone I really like.
First? You mean you haven't kissed anyone before?
Forget that! Cross out what I just said! Please?
Alright, I'll forget I heard that. In exchange, you're not allowed to forget your lines out there, alright?
Yeah, it's probably a little too soon for me to fully awaken as an actress, but I'll try as hard as I can to maybe at least half awaken.
That's the spirit, Yukiho. Okay, have you had just about enough of a break?
But, producer, does the stage seem kind of noisy to you all of a sudden?
Does look like there's some kind of panic going on over there, at least. Is it part of a scene, or...?
I'm going to go ask and see if anything happened.
I sure hope nothing happened. I'd hate for it to be.
Producer! Producer, it's a big, huge emergency! The director, they said she decided to throw out the whole last scene and do a different one!
What?! Just now?! How unreasonable can she be?! We've scarcely got 2 hours before we have to open, don't we?!
Producer! Well, what do we do now?
I don't know! I first I have to not die! I don't know, but first we have to... Calm down! Just calm down.
Right. But I mean, can we calm down all... But we can calm down all we like, but we're still no closer to figuring out what to do.
It'll be fine. If we're calm, we can think clearly about it, and what needs to be done will naturally occur to us.
What needs to be done? Yeah, you're right. What it comes down to is, we really have no choice but to memorize the new scene, do we?
That's right. It's the director's prerogative what she wants to do with her own show, not our place to question it. Do you think you can pull it off?
Doesn't matter at this point. I just have to. Please, leave it to me. Oh, but, if I don't get some water to drink first or something, I might actually die. Water!
Yukiho's determined to see this through, which is good, but she's definitely feeling the strain. Honestly, it's the director's fault for replacing an entire scene last minute. She shouldn't have to put up with this shit from her. Is there really nothing I can do? No. I'll trust her with it. This isn't something I can or should be doing anything about.
Ah! I feel so relieved with some nice cold
Try
water down-
Try that again.
Oh. Ah! I feel so revived with some nice cold water down my throat. Okay, producer, I'll be getting back to work now.
Yukiho! Just one more thing.
Yes?
You can do it. I can't do anything but watch out for you from over here, but I'll be watching like my life depended on it.
Okay. That's all I need, producer. Just knowing you're looking after me makes me so happy. So I'm going to go over there and I'm going to do this! I'm ready now, director!
I have never felt so powerless and frustrated as I do right now. Please be all right, Yukiho. During the opening performance...
Come on, everyone! Let's dance together! Don't let these hot summer days get you down!
Undaunted by the director's unreasonable demands, Yukiho nailed the new final scene to close the curtain on a perfect opening night. An idol has no one but herself to rely on when she's on the stage. Yukiho knew this, of course, but where she might have complained or hesitated before, now she's adapted to it beautifully. I don't think the dazzling gleam around her is just from the spotlight today.
Ladies and gentlemen, may we have a huge round of applause for our magnificent cast. Without them, tonight's show truly would not have been possible. Thank you all so much. Hey, didn't I play this role too?
I think I had you back up. And... Yeah, I had you back it up for me, and I think the person that I had assigned it to didn't actually deliver it, or maybe they did at the last second or something.
I can't remember. I remember recording these lines, though.
I remember hearing them in your voice.
Producer, could you see me well enough from where you were standing in the wings?
Of course, I saw everything! You looked like a completely different person out on that stage, Yukiho! It was like...
What?
Never mind. Say, why don't we all go out and celebrate your successful opening night with a round of tropical juice?
Oh, good idea! Okay then, I'll go get the others!
Like a brilliant, shining star lighting up the stage. But there can be no resting on laurels for us. No matter what happens, it's my job to help these girls always shine even brighter.
Is that the actual name of this scene?
Mm-mm. Remember, these scenes don't have titles in the game that I know of.
So you came up with this yourself. I was like, wait a minute, that game wasn't out yet. Okay.
We came to this amusement park to shoot a commercial for our music today. Honestly, I've been...
Deep breath.
We came to this amusement park to shoot a commercial for our music. Where am I going with this? We came to this amusement park to shoot a commercial for our music today. Honestly, I've been wanting to take the girls here for a while.
Wow! I know we're here for work, producer, but I just can't help but start feeling all bouncy from looking around!
Yes, I can see that. Looks like this place has really brought out the kid in you, huh?
I really have to say that Miku outfit looks really cute on her.
Yeah, because you can see on their faces everyone around us is having so much fun. Feels like I'm soaking in pure happiness.
I understand the feeling. When everyone around you is happy, it has a way of rubbing off on you.
Uh-huh.
Are you satisfied with that, though? Speaking personally, it'd make me even happier if I could join in on the fun myself.
You might be right. If everyone else around me was having fun and all I got to do was watch, I think I'd start feeling a little lonely.
Kagame, oh Kagame, Kagame.
No. I've done that creepypasta. I can't listen to that song.
Yeah, well, I didn't want that to happen, so I bought you a present. This is just a small happiness I can give to you.
Really? What is it? What did you get for me, producer?
All right, settle down. Now that I have your attention. Ta-da! There you go. I've always loved these balloons. Their fun, bouncy floatiness just feels like it belongs at an amusement park, doesn't it?
Wow! Thank you, producer! This makes me so happy! I mean, not only do I think they're pretty cute, too, but I think this might be the first time I've ever gotten a present from a boy, too, so...
I'm almost positive that's not true. You get tons of presents from your fans in the office mail, and certainly when we... You get tons of presents from your fans in the office mail, and certainly when we do events.
Yeah, I know, but that's just because we're...
Oh, I was looking at that like, wait a minute.
Yeah, I know, but that's just because we're fan and idol. This is its own thing. Let me have my moment.
Alright then, as long as you're happy with it, that's fine with me. But,
was there a but, producer?
There's actually another reason I got you those balloons. I had an idea about using them in today's shoot.
How are we gonna do that?
Well, what I'm picturing is you girls carrying the balloons together and then releasing them all into the sky at the end. How's that sound?
Wow, that sounds so pretty. Yeah, I like it, and I'm sure the others will too.
Great. So, one thing I'd like is a cool shot of you slowly coming into the foreground with your balloons, which I thought would be easiest to pull off if we had the three of you riding something and tied the balloons onto it all around you.
Riding something? You mean maybe something like one of those platform carts?
What? I was kind of hoping for something with a more larger-than-life element to it. Not anything so mundane as a handcart. We are at an amusement park, after all. There are plenty of actual rides available with a more fantastical feel to them. You know, like... The merry-go-round is what I was thinking of.
The merry-go-round? Oh! And that means we get to do the shot riding around on the horses!
Actually, I was thinking of having you ride in the chariot.
What? Why the chariot?
Well, first because we can cram all three of you onto it at once, and it'll be more impactful to show off how friendly you are with each other. Because, you know, Japan and personal space. But also, wouldn't it feel more romantic to have this lavish, intricate, mystical chariot emerging into frame, too?
Yes, you're right! We'd
We'd probably look like just like three Cinderellas going to the ball.
Going to the ball.
Together!
I'm sorry.
Oh, yes! I like that image. Good one, Yukiho. I think you in particular would make a perfect Cinderella girl.
Only if it's the first Cinderella girl game, because she's not in the recent one.
No, that's not true! I'm happy where I am now, thank you very much. Never mind me, what role are you going to play, producer? You're going to play the prince from the castle, aren't you?
Me? I wish. But I could be the fairy godfather sending you all to the castle. You ready to get started?
Yeah, okay then. Please help us get to the ball with your magic fairy god producer.
And... and so we talked it over with the director and worked our ideas into the shoot. We all had a lot of fun, and it turned out just as adorable as I imagined. Yukiho seemed really happy with it, too. Today was a good day.
References!
We came out to the ski resort to film today's commercial. This one's for local broadcasting only.
Producer, remind me again why we had to come all the way out to a ski slope today, and in school uniforms, less?
Oh yeah, about that. Apparently a snow-covered landscape was the first thing the director thought of when he heard one of our members is named Yukiho.
That's what happened? But come to think of it, I guess it might make this commercial a bit, a helpful mnemonic for people to remember my name.
Yeah, could be. I know it's a little chilly, but always best to look on the bright side, especially when we've got a commercial to turn out.
Yeah, however cold we may get, we have to at least take the opportunity to advertise our music. So it won't be all for nothing.
Good. Guess that outlook helped her motivate herself. Never thought the day would come when we'd be filming her going for an actual gentle walk across the snow. This should make for a pretty interesting shoot. So, today the girls are shooting a commercial for this horror movie they're singing the opening theme for. It's supposed to consist of all of them sharing a brief thought on it after having watched it, but... yeah. Horror.
No, 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 never! I can't do this! You can't make me! I want to go home!
Shh, Yukiho, please try to settle down a little. Believe me, I understand how you feel. Had I known we'd actually have to watch this 13-day grudge of the cursed orphans, I never would have taken this job, but...
See? Even you really don't want to watch it, producer! There can't be anyone in the whole world who wants to watch it less than me! If I had to sit through such a scary movie, I don't think I'd get a peaceful night's sleep ever again! I just can't do it! I'm going home!
Yukiho! Please! Now you're just throwing a tantrum! I told you already, we don't have a choice but to tough it out!
It's too much to ask, producer! Would you mind if I asked you to get kicked by a horse?
Alright, I know it's partially my fault, so I'll make you a deal. If you end up too scared to sleep at night... I'll come over and sleep next to you. If it'd set your mind at ease.
Producer? Did you really do that for me?
Of course. I don't go back on my word.
Okay. But security is extremely tight at my house, so I don't think you'd be able to get into my room at all without some specialized training.
Huh. You mean like a metal GIT- WAIT! Why are we talking about this now?
Are you saying it's no good unless I actually break into your room at night, too?
Yes. Don't you think it would be more romantic if we did it that way? I can just imagine. There I am, tossing and turning in the dead of night, when my producer suddenly appears at my window and comes over and gently strokes my hair all. Shh, shh, there, there. It's okay. And I'd have no idea whether I'm dreaming or not. That sensation would help me sleep so peacefully. So what do you think? Doesn't that sound wonderful?
I think it's debatable whether that counts as romantic or just plain creepy. But I've made my bed, haven't I? And now I have to sleep in it. I promise, Yukiho, we'll work something out.
You really promise? Okay then, maybe I can go ahead and try watching the movie, since it's at least a little less likely I won't be able to sleep.
What have I gotten myself into? I did manage to avoid having her walk out on me, but I think I just traded away several years of my life in exchange. I need to review my techniques. But anyway, she and I watched the movie together.
Jump scare warning!
The very first...
We might need to put that in the description.
Screw that, that's the point.
So many hate comments are on the way.
The very first thing it does is rack the audience with a blood-curdling screech that sounds more like a sick person trying to get over a chest cold screaming into a pillow. Or an elephant, okay. This movie's actually pretty gruesome. I really hope poor Yukiho will be alright. There, Yukiho, the movie's finally over. Let's get this shoot over with. I can imagine what you must want to say about it, but we have to at least try to put in a good word for... Yukiho? You still with me? Your eyes are kind of glazed over. Hey, Travis.
Hey, Travis!
No, don't tell me you passed out on your feet! This is bad. Come on, wake up! There's gotta be something I can do to snap her out of it! But, wait, she did just watch a whole horror movie, so...
Yeah, let's not. If I were to touch her anywhere now, it'd probably just spook her real bad.
What was I?
Yukiho, you came around! Thank goodness, you really had me worried for a minute there.
I remember I was watching that movie, just focusing on getting through it so we could shoot the commercial afterwards, and then...
Ah, so the thought of doing the commercial kick-started you back to consciousness, or something? Well, you have always been a pretty hard worker. Thank goodness for force of habit. But if that's the case, is that all you can remember? I guess you've completely forgotten the actual content of the movie?
No, I haven't forgotten. It was actually pretty...
Trail off, sorry.
It was actually pretty...
It was actually pretty... What, Yukiho?
It was thrilling and suspenseful and actually pretty fun to watch! And especially whenever it made me scream, your hand was right there!
My hand? Did something about my hand scare you too?
That part's a secret. Anyway, it made me realize there are actually nice things about horror movies I hadn't thought of before, so...
Now I know exactly what I can talk about for the commercial. Producer, we should watch a horror movie together again sometime. Yeah, how about it, Hana? Let's watch a horror movie together.
That part's a secret.
And with that, she happily skipped over to the recording booth. I don't think I can say how exactly, but looks like she was able to find her own way to overcome her fear. I'm just glad we didn't get stuck with the wrong end of this corpse party.
The reference!
Also, you notice how he didn't respond at all to me saying, let's go watch a horror movie?
Yeah, because I'm the Yukiho and you're the producer in that case.
No, the producer didn't want to watch it.
Neither did she!
Exactly! So if I were the producer, I wouldn't want to watch the movie.
Fuck.
I like scary movies.
Well, I'm still the Yukiho, and
I'm... But my hand will be right there.
I think you're going to find yourself wanting for a bit more than your hand.
Hey, it can't be worse than Izumi. My entire arm went numb during Paranormal Activity 2, because she was clinging to it so hard.
So, the girl's got a spot on this TV show, Top Star. It's a documentary-type show that interviews different types of celebrities and looks back on how and why they got their start. Come on, Yukiho, the fact that you were invited onto this show at all proves you're real celebrities now! You've worked really hard for that recognition. Just this once, it's okay to feel proud of yourself and tell everyone all about it.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Alright, seriously, what's the matter? You've looked awfully upset about something for a while now.
Well, it's just I still can't decide what I'm going to talk about at all today.
Oh, really? It's giving you that much trouble?
Uh-huh. I guess I just have too many things I want to talk about. It's a little hard to decide where to start, or how to put it all together, or...
Well, that's not exactly a bad problem to have, you know. We have done a lot of good work together this past year, but the program is mostly interested in up to the point we really hit it big, so nominally... I guess your favorite songs or past experiences with singing would be a good place to start.
Experiences with singing, huh? Yeah, I think that I could do that. There are all kinds of things I could talk about when it comes to singing. Like, one thing I find myself doing a lot is humming to myself in the bath and stuff at home, since we're always doing so many lessons.
Yeah, that's good. Things like that would be interesting to hear about, I think.
You think so? That's a bit of a relief, I guess, but still.
What, Yukiho? Is there something else? You have a topic you can focus on in the beginning now, right?
Yeah, I know, but I just can't do it! I can't!
Come on, Yukiho, talk to me. Please try to calm down and tell me what's still bothering you. I'll listen.
It's just, if I start reminiscing about too many things, I'm pretty sure I'm going to start crying memory tears!
What? Memory tears? That's a thing?
It is for me! I just know that whenever I try to talk about... I just know that whenever I try to talk about, I'm going to get all emotional right in the middle of it, and... Hey, that's something I do. And then I'll start sobbing and probably ruin the take, and then they'll have to stop the recording and wait for me because of it! Shut up! Shut up! I'm starting to feel like I should change who I cosplay. I'm more like Yukiho than I am Chihaya.
I see. Is that all you're worried about?
Ah,
producer! I know you said it's okay in front of you, but I'm still really worried about making a scene in front of everyone else!
I know, Yukiho, and I wasn't trying to make light of your feelings, I'm sorry. What I meant was you don't need to worry about the show, okay? It's okay to cry in front of the camera if you need to.
But we won't be able to keep doing the interview as long as I'm crying, and they can't use that on the show!
Yukiho, the only time they have to stop is if you stop expressing yourself to the viewers. And you know what? There are many important things in life that can't be expressed in mere words. Like the feeling of having a relationship on the other side of a glass wall. That's what I think.
I'm going to hurt you.
And I'm going to like it. And that's... I love you.
I love you too.
I'm sorry.
Just continue the scene.
And that's why I'm convinced that when you cry your memory tears, you'll be able to communicate the depth of your feelings to the viewers without even having to say anything.
I can communicate with my tears?
That's right. So if you need to cry in there, I want you to go ahead and cry. So much that you make everyone worry about you.
Alright, I understand. I guess if there's one thing I know I'll always be good at, it is crying after all. Besides, I'd like it if I could communicate to everyone else that sometimes crying can be a way to communicate too.
With that, she calmly headed straight for the studio. I don't have a clue what'll really end up happening in there, but I have faith that Yukiho's feelings will get through to the viewers, and even the staff. She always gets them through to me when it comes down to it.
Okay, we're not going to get into our kinks on this show.
Well.
But he does have me to blame for that.
It's okay. I'm only mostly kidding. Because I know it'd amuse you. Murmur, murmur, audience, audience. So the girls finished up a part as models in this new movie Stardom Bound this week, and today they've been asked to speak at a press conference about it. The other girls went earlier, and now it's Yukiho's turn to answer questions.
Hagiwara-san, my readers will want to know what was the one thing you had the Hagiwara-san, my readers will want to know what was the one thing you had to be most careful about while you were filming. I would have to say my health. When working on a project like this, just a single day you take off can make things extremely difficult for several other people, you see.
Clap, 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 clap.
Oh, no, no, that's really not anything you need to applaud me for. I mean, that sort of commitment is something that's expected of me anyway as an idol.
You know, I wouldn't have thought this sort of affair to really be to Yukiho's liking, but she's presenting herself like an industry vet up there.
I was the reporter, you can be the host.
I'm All right. But this part has always been a girl.
Oh, okay.
All right, everyone. We're going to conclude the interview segment here. Thank you all for your questions.
I'd like to say thank you to all of you, too. I hope you'll all look forward to the release of Stardom Bound. It's finally over, producer.
You did an amazing job, Yukiho. You were so confident and dignified. Everyone was really impressed.
Were they really? I'm happy to hear that. I remember this scene.
All three of you were brilliant up there, really. It makes me so happy and proud to see how much you've grown.
I have to get my asses so ready. I
can hardly believe you're praising us so much for it, producer. I guess our good luck charm must have really worked wonders.
Your good luck charm? What do you mean? Did you cast some kind of success charm earlier?
Yes, we did. Azusa-san taught it to me, so I thought maybe the three of us could all try it together.
And so you cast it to wish for good luck with the conference. I'm actually a little curious how it works now.
You have everyone sit in a circle and pass around a cup of tea with everyone, taking a sip. And while you're doing that, everyone has to imagine the event going well.
Huh. And just doing that will grant you all success?
No, that's just one part of it. You have to perform that ritual once at 6 a.m., once at 2 p.m., and once at 10 p.m., all on the same day or it won't work. Also, if even one person in the group is thinking evil thoughts while you're doing it, then the charm is supposed to bring disaster to all of you instead.
I see. So the conditions for invoking it are actually pretty strict.
Yes, but that's what makes it all... Yes, but that's what makes it work so well. I'm so glad we managed to do it right.
Yeah, all right then. Maybe we could cast that charm to wish that we'll win the Grand Prix, too.
Sadly, no. We can't anymore.
Really? Uh-oh. Why not?
That's because this particular charm doesn't work if anyone in the ritual has done it already. We'd have to find a different one to use for the Grand Prix.
Well, I'm sure we could, but I'm no expert in these things like you are. Do you know any other good ones?
I do know one really good one, but the ritual for it is pretty complicated. It'd probably be a little too difficult for me right now.
Aw. Oh well, nothing more we can do about it for now, I guess. You want to go get changed so we can start heading back?
Excuse me! Is the 765 producer still here?
What's going on? Yes, I'm here, miss. Do you need something?
Yes! I'm sorry, but there was a mistake in the scheduling, and several reporters weren't present for your idol's interview. The sponsor would like you to hold one more 10-minute session. Please?
You mean we have to go back out there and do another interview?
I'm terribly sorry about all this. Please call me as soon as you're ready! Please don't hate me. I'd understand if you never wanted to see me again or didn't want to be my friend now, but I'm just going to go over here and be by myself in the corner. I'm sorry.
Didn't see that one coming. But, hey, if you carry yourself just like you were doing earlier, I'm sure you'll be fine.
But, producer, what if the effect of our good luck charm has already run out?
Oh, yeah, guess it might have, since technically your wish came true once already, so...
So then, would you be willing to help me cast a new charm, producer? All you have to do for the ritual is touch me. Please pick somewhere on my body and touch me.
Hold on, Yukio. What do you mean, somewhere? Where exactly?
It won't work if I tell you that, producer. You have to guess and touch me as close as you can to where I'm thinking that I want you to. That's what makes it good luck.
Okay, that kind of reminds me of... So, in a way, it depends on how compatible she and I are? All right, then. I choose... this spot.
Producer!
Sorry, I guess your forehead was way off the mark. Did I screw it up?
No! My forehead was exactly what I was thinking! How did you do that? Amazing! You just keep getting more and more amazing, producer!
Come on, Yukiho, cut it out! Pretty sure I'm not that amazing. Look, you're ready now, right? You should get going.
Okay. Then I'll go get the girls. We're going to have the best interview ever now!
There's that smile. I know she's into fortune-telling and stuff, but it's still hard to believe how much faith in herself a simple good luck charm can instill. After all, it's her own abilities that she has to thank for her success, not any sort of magical powers. I was hoping she'd be more aware of that by now.
Hana! Well, producer-san, sometimes it takes more than simple logic to move a girl's heart, you know?
Oh! Hello, Azusa-san. I didn't know you'd be at the conference, too. But that's right, you three all got cameo roles in the movie, didn't you?
Yes, we did. But getting back to the matter at hand, we girls tend to treat good luck charms with much more gravity than you might realize. They give us something outside ourselves to look to for comfort and support when our own wills start to falter, even if it's something small and simple.
Huh. Is that what's going on? I thought it was weird how just giving her a light tap on the forehead could make her so much more...
Oh? I'm sorry, her forehead? You mean you actually cast the luck... I see how it is. Oh, Yukiho-chan, you can be quite the cheeky little vixen, can't you?
Azusa-san, is there something I should know about that charm that I didn't?
No. Not anything in particular that I'm aware of, I think. Oh, I do hope the one I'm destined for will come and find me soon.
Well, anyway, the girl's second interview did go just as well as the first. Even better, actually. Small, simple things that girls look to for support, huh? I think the subtleties of such things are a bit beyond me for now. I have a funny feeling that unless I can master them, I'm gonna have a lot more troubles ahead of me, both on and off the job.